Hi, we're Nick and Valerie Wisniewski on behalf of expertvillage.com. We're here to talk about animal tracks. For more information, please visit our website, walnuthilltracking.com. Here on the ground, we have the tracks of two wild animals, and we're going to compare these two. One of these is a wild feline. It's actually the track of a bobcat. The other is a wild canine. It's actually an eastern coyote. When comparing these two tracks, it's often easy to confuse them, but there are several important features that will help you distinguish cat tracks from dog tracks. On the cat track, you can see that the heel pad, in general, is a much larger feature in proportion to the whole track than in the canine, where the heel pad is a much smaller feature in proportion to the whole. In general, also, the outline of the track is different. The feline track is generally oval, sideways, or round. It gives a general roundness. The coyote track, or the dog track, on the other hand, is oval, oriented front to back. So when you quickly glance at these, the first impression is this track is oval, and this track is round, or even slightly wider than it is long. Other important features are the toes. The toes on the feline track actually point in a slightly different direction than the heel seems to be pointing. This gives it a certain asymmetry, which is characteristic of cat tracks. In the dog track, however, the coyote track, the toes and the heel point in the same direction, so it is symmetrical. Another feature is the negative space between the heel pad and the toes. On the feline track, that negative space makes a C shape. In the dog track, however, what's left in the middle, the negative space, is a pyramid with an X through it. The X is a very good diagnostic key to a wild dog track.